training camp. The shenanigans begin. Let's go.
Jerick, how bad did you feel like Isaiah wants to be able to do everything right now?
Very bad. I mean, everybody knows the energy he brings. You know, his motor, the way he's engine and the way he works. But, you know, at the same time, it's a process. And, you know, not only is it about, you know, camp right now, it's about down the road and being healthy for the season and then, you know, having that durability lasting the season. So we know how bad he wants to be out there, but at the same time, he has to take care of himself, get to 100%, and then be available for the team.
Just knowing how many years you have in the league, how are you kind of tempering that in order to get ready, but also be there for
the team? Say what's on?
Just considering how many years you have in the league, how are you tempering
You know, it's all about being smart. You know, obviously, it's training camp. We're going to come out, we're going to work hard every day, we're going to run hard every day. But at the same time, you know, away from, you know, being on the field and away from meetings, you know, you got to take care of your body. You got to make sure, you know, at the beginning of the day, you start at 100%. Obviously, you knock down with the exercise and all that stuff, the workouts. So whatever it takes between the end of that time and the next day, you got to prepare yourself to get back as close as you can to that 100%. You never really fully reach it, but, you know, there's nothing stopping you from still trying to reach each and every day to get back up being 100%.
Look at your career. If I told you when you first started way back when at the Vikings that this is how your career would have gone, would that surprise you in any way?
As far as what?
What's that?
As far as what exactly? Just in general?
Yeah.
Maybe the injuries, yeah. But as far as just, you know, lasting and, you know, making it this point in my career, nah, it's something that I set out for myself. You know, I work hard to get to this point, stay at this point. So as far as that aspect, no, but in the terms of other things, yes.
Jerick, given the way the league is operating right now,
yeah,
you've had multiple contracts, you played in multiple teams. From your perspective, what is interesting right now to you about how the running back market is going in the league? And I guess what is most frustrating given you've been obviously in those negotiations as a running back?
It's very tough. You know, the running back position, it's a lot of demand on that position. As far as, you know, running the ball in between tackles, you know, taking that beat in, you know, nowadays, basically turning to a receiver out the backfield, pass blocking, no protections. So, you know, definitely in that aspect, the position is along the way been devalued because it's such a passing league. When you step back and look at it, it's definitely something that should be more valued than what it is. And as far as, you know, the contract situations, I guess it's kind of based on the market. So it's kind of hard to really say, you know, how that happens. You know, it's at every position every year. You know, it fluctuates. You know, you got a guy who gets paid this much. He sets the market. Everybody kind of gets their contract off of that guy. This year it's been kind of difficult. The top running backs being franchise tagged. So, you know, when the top guys get franchise tagged, you know, that's the ceiling. So everybody else falls under that. So, as far as the guys getting franchise tag, you know, I feel them on that side. You know, they put in their work, they pay their dues. They're looking for a payday, a long term, some guarantee. It's just one of those things that, you know, it's kind of bittersweet about the game and the business part, you know, when it comes down to that.
Jerick, Patrick Mahomes basically.
I've been looking to see you too. How you doing?
No, I am so happy. But Patrick basically called you Yoda.
Yeah.
Like, you can even call the plays. You know so much, you've studied so much. How do you feel you and Patrick have evolved in a way that allows that to happen? And do you feel that's an essential part of what you do, adding that wisdom to the offense?
Definitely. You know, just having my quarterback background in college and then playing, like you said, playing in multiple systems and, you know, being able to see the overall view of the offense, not just from, you know, running back position. It definitely benefits me coming into the game and, you know, being on the same page with Patrick. I think last year definitely showed being on the same page, you know, hooking up multiple times, touchdowns here and there. So I definitely think it benefited. So for me, it's about, you know, taking what I learned and, you know, trying to trickle it down to the younger guys and help them understand, you know, the overall view so that, you know, no matter who's in there, it's the same result.
But do you feel like Yoda?
I feel young. I still got the juice. I don't know about Yoda. Well seasoned.
Jerick, you still got the juice. I wonder what you think it took to get through that period of the injuries, mm-hmm, and the increasing age at the time. I mean, what inside you do you think drove that?
Just my will, heart. That's not a tough injury to come back from. You know, seen guys come back better than before. You've seen some guys come back not better than before. So, you know, that's just a testament to will. You know, God, believing in God, you know, family, friends, close ones, my teammates. You know, and everybody, you know, just contributing power into me and just being a driving motivator, motivation.
You said you're surprised by what happened since you were able to.
Nah.
All this happened since then.
Nah, I put that work in, I came back, and everything else is just a reflection of, you know, the work that I put in back then. Essentially, he's a coach. I don't know if y'all seen group install. You know, sometimes he stops the whole practice just to get, you know, what he wants, what he's envisioning, you know, across into the receivers. It's the same way in meeting, same way in walkthrough. So he definitely has that freedom, the control within the offense. And then, you know, just his leadership. You know, everybody knows how big that is when he's out there, his presence and stuff like that. It's more of how he expects to want things to be done. So more of communication, so there's no miscommunication. You know, everybody knows when there's miscommunication, nothing good happens from that. So it's just about, you know, being outspoken, make sure everybody's on the same page, and come out and execute.
Last one here. Charles was talking about being excited for the pads to come on, the physicality, things like that. As a running back, are you as excited for the pads to come on? Or?
I mean, that's what it's about. We're going to run the ball. I don't know if y'all been seeing the last couple of days. I've probably had like 4 runs. So the pass coming on means we're going to get the touch ball a little bit more. The guys up front, we're going to get some push. It's going to be some real competition in the trenches. And then we're going to get to see what all the guys do with the ball in their hands. And then we're going to see what the linebackers do. The safeties coming down, what they get to do. And it's going to be fun. We get to the real football now.
Thanks, guys.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.